So when I first heard about this school that was being put together, I thought, great, finally. Obviously, this is exactly what we need. Thank goodness someone else is doing it so I don't have to, because I'm too busy to do it. And I wish it was around when I was a kid. I went home after hearing about it and I said to Simon, so Simon, I was at a talk and we were talking about making a new school where it's a little bit different, where the kids get to decide what they want to learn and create and invent, and the adults help them do that. They ask them questions and they support you so that you can go out and figure out how to do the things you want to do and learn the things you want to do. So he turned to me with this look of wonder and said, that's exactly what I like. As if magically someone knew exactly what he wanted to do in school and wasn't able to do. So I knew right then, I said, for sure.
It's something I always don't look forward to and I'm sad about, and I'm also always super happy whenever it ends, or if the weekend or a break like Sunday.
Yeah. What really broke my heart was one day I was talking with him about school, and we've been trying to make that environment work for him. We've been working with him on what he can do, talking to the teachers who are amazing. Little things, maybe bringing in worksheets. Some ideas worked, some didn't. None of it's made a big impact though. And I was talking to him about, you know, maybe there's another school out there, there's someone I've heard of where, you know, you could, you know, really enjoy learning about things. And he looked at me and he said, I can't imagine enjoying learning. That broke my heart. Yeah. I didn't get that way until grade 7. He's only in grade 2. And it took me years to undo that in myself. I just thought it's too early for him to feel that way. He's not even being graded or anything. It's just that whole environment is not stimulating him, not challenging him in the ways he wants to be challenged. And he doesn't have the choices. He's big on choice. He wants to decide things and he thrives on that. He taught himself to read from Pokemon cards because he was interested in it. He taught himself math at a higher level because he was interested in how much pocket money he'd have to save to buy the things he wanted to buy. So I know that that's how he learns. It's pretty much how everyone learns.
So I might not feel completely happy and excited, but I think I'll feel happier and less worried and sad about going.
The biggest thing that's not working is how he feels about it. He'll often get stomach aches on Sunday night, or Monday morning he'll get a stomach ache. He'll often cry because he just does not like the environment. And I'll talk him through it. We've got this high five we do for 5 good things about the day, and then we do a high five. So he goes, and he's learned over the last 3 years to be stoic and do well in that environment. In terms of teacher feedback, teachers think he loves it. He gets on well with other kids. They're always surprised when I come to them and say, so Simon really doesn't like school. What can we do about that? And often halfway through the school year, he's done, because it's just more of the same. At least there was a new teacher or something new for a while. then it's done. It's based on what a child is interested in and feels good about and wants to. It's capturing that excitement of learning again, where they want to know something, and then working with that so that they do take that learning further, but with support and different kinds of support too, asking questions instead of just being told what to do, and being stimulated and creative at all different levels. Basically, even as an adult, I would like that. I would love to think, oh, wow, I want to learn more about this, and there are a bunch of adults around me who are going to help me not even find the answers, but ask more questions and learn more things and help me produce something that I want to produce. So I want that for him for sure. I first of all hope he'd be happy. And secondly, hope that he learns to enjoy learning again. That he gets excited about learning. And he does at home when he thinks it's not learning. But in a school environment where he can feel confident that he can be interested in what he is already interested in, and then learn more about it and go on tangents and learn different things and go out into the community and learn something there and just have different experiences and excel and accelerate his learning, because I know what he has learned, when he is interested in something, he learns super fast and at a very high level. I'm curious with all adults how they found school for themselves, first of all. Because a lot of adults seem to think it's very important to go to school, and yet when they talk about their own schooling, they feel like they didn't learn much, they didn't like school, they didn't come out of it with a passion for learning and for thinking for themselves and thinking creatively. And I would say have confidence in your own experiences and your own thoughts of what education could and should be. I did very well in school, even though I really didn't like it. And maybe that's given me the confidence to say, I don't need it. It was a waste of my learning time. And so for parents whose children are struggling in a regular school, I would say, here's an alternative, great. But even for children who are doing well, for example, my daughter, I know she's gonna do great. She's only in preschool, but she is very social, takes what's given to her. She will thrive in a regular public school, but even so, I plan on switching her to Simon School, because I think the type of learning she will do will be so much richer. Even when I went to school, the point of school and doing well in school, I felt as a student, was doing more school, going on to university. And the point of that was to get a good job in an office. And even then, the office jobs that I got into didn't even care about the school as much, the schooling that I'd had, as much as I thought. But if you think about the kind of job that you want for your child, if you want them to be in a job where they're feeling enthusiasm, where they're connecting with people, where they're continually learning and actually doing something good in the world, then they need to go to a school where they are excited about learning, continually asking questions, working with other people, going out into the community and learning in that community.
Such animals, because I'm really interested in seeing wildlife and wildlife. And I haven't thought much about that because I'm filled with hoping for me to get the toy for him, Dad. But trying to think about what I do when I get it.